Hello friends, welcome back to the design patterns video series. In this video, I'm going to discuss the factory design pattern in C# with one real-time example. Please watch our previous video where we discussed shallow copy versus deep copy in C# with examples. The factory design pattern is one of the most frequently used design patterns in real-time applications. The factory design pattern falls under the category of creational design pattern, and hence it is basically used to manage the object creation and initialization. As part of this video, we are going to discuss the following pointers. First, we will discuss what is factory design pattern. Then we will understand the factory design pattern with one real-time example. Then we will implement one example without following the factory design pattern. Then we will understand the problems of not following the factory design pattern. Then we will implement the same example using the factory design pattern in C#. Then we will discuss when to use factory design pattern in real-time applications. And finally, we will discuss what are the problems of the simple factory design pattern and how we can overcome the problems of simple factory design patterns. Let us first try to understand the definitions of factory design pattern. According to Gang of Four, the factory design pattern states that a factory is an object which is used for creating other objects. In technical terms, we can say that a factory is a class with a method, and that factory method will take the responsibility to create and return different types of object based on the input parameter it received. In simple words, we can say that if we have a superclass and n number of subclasses, and based on the input data provided, if we have to create and return the object of one of the subclasses, then we need to use the factory design pattern. In factory design pattern, we create an object without exposing the object creation logic to the client, and the client will refer to the newly created object using a common interface. The basic principle behind the factory design pattern is that at runtime, we get an object of a similar type based on the parameter we pass. If you are not understanding the above points, then don't worry, we will explain the same with one real-time example. Let us understand the factory design pattern with one real-time example. Suppose we want to develop an application for showing the credit card details. For better understanding, please have a look at the above diagram. Here, as you can see, we have three credit card classes: Moneyback, Platinum, and Titanium. And all these three classes are the subclasses of credit card superclass, or you can say credit card super interface. The credit card superclass or the credit card super interface has three abstract methods, that is get card type, get credit limit, and get annual charge. The subclasses, that is Moneyback, Platinum, and Titanium, implement the credit card super interface and provide implementation to all these three methods, right? Our business requirement is we will ask the user to select the credit card type, and once the user selects the credit card type, then we need to display the required information of that selected credit card. For example, if the user select the Moneyback credit card, then we will display the Moneyback credit card related information, that is the methods, that is all these three methods which are implemented inside the Moneyback credit card should be executed. Similarly, if the user selected the Titanium credit card, then the methods which are implemented inside the Titanium credit card class should be executed. Let us first discuss how to achieve this without using the factory design pattern. Then we will discuss the problems of not following the factory design pattern. And finally, we will create the same application using the factory design pattern. So basically, we are going to follow three steps. In step one, we will create the product interface, that is the credit card interface, with the required method signature, that is abstract methods. In the second step, we will create the product classes, that is Moneyback, Titanium, and Platinum, and implementing the credit card interface and providing implementation to the credit card interface method. That is the Moneyback, Titanium, and Platinum, all these classes will implement the credit card interface and provide implementation to all the abstract methods which are declared inside the credit card interface, right? And in the final step, that is in the client code, we will ask the user to select the credit card type, and based on the selected credit card, we will create an instance of any of the three product implementation classes, that is Moneyback, Titanium and Platinum, and then call the method. So let us move to Visual Studio and implement this example step by step. So far what I have done is I have created a console application with the name Factory Design Pattern Demo. Then I have added few classes to this application, as you can see here, right? So the step one is to create the product interface. Here we need to create either an interface or an abstract class that will expose the operations a credit card should have. So I have created one interface with the name creditcard.cs, right? As part of this interface, I have declared three methods, that is get credit card type, get credit limit, get annual charge. If you want to expose more methods as part of the credit card, then you need to declare all those methods here only. The step two is to create product classes. As per our business requirement, we need to create three product classes, that is Moneyback, Titanium and Platinum, that will implement this credit card interface and providing implementation to these three methods, right? So far what I have done is I have added three classes, that is Moneyback, Platinum and Titanium. If you look at the implementation of the Moneyback class, then you will see that this Moneyback class implement the credit card interface and providing implementation to the get credit card type, get credit limit and get annual charge methods. And we also need to do the same thing for Platinum and Titanium classes. The Titanium class implements the credit card interface and providing implementation for all the three methods. And we also do the same thing for the Platinum class as well. So the step three is the client code. That is the main method of our application. So this is the program class having the main method. Now in the client code, we will ask the user to select the credit card type. And based on the selected credit card type, we'll create an instance of any of the three product implementation classes, that is Moneyback, Platinum and Titanium. Right. Generally, we will get the credit card type from UI, but here we have hard-coded the credit card type, that is Moneyback. Then we created one reference variable of type credit card and set its value to null. Right. Then based on the credit card type, we are creating the appropriate type instance using the if-else condition. If the credit card type is Moneyback, then we are creating an instance of a Moneyback class. If the credit card type is Titanium, then we are creating an instance of Titanium. And if the credit card type is Platinum, then we are creating an instance of a Platinum class and storing that instance in the credit card reference variable. This credit card reference variable is the, this credit card interface is the super class for all these three product classes. This is the reason why we can store the instance of these classes within the credit card reference variable. Once we created the instance of a specific card type, then we are just calling the card type get credit limit get annual charge method to display the credit card information on the console window. So when you will run the application, then you will get the output as expected. We are getting the output as expected. Then what is the problem of the above code implementation? Let us move to the presentation. The way we implement the code introduces two problems. The first problem is the tight coupling between the client class, that is the program class, and the product classes, that is Moneyback, Titanium and Platinum classes. That means if we do any changes in the product classes, then also we need to do the changes in the client classes because of the tight coupling behavior. The second problem is if we add a new credit card, then also we need to modify the main method of the program class, that is in the client code, by adding an extra if-else condition, which not only overrides in the development, but also in the testing process. Let us see how to overcome the above problem by using the factory design pattern. As per the definition of factory design pattern, the factory design pattern creates an object without exposing the object creation logic to the client. And the client refers to the newly created object using a common interface. For better understanding, please have a look at the image. This is going to be our vector class, and this class will take the responsibility of creating and returning the appropriate product object. As you can see, this class is having one static method, that is getCreditCard, and this static method taking one input parameter, that is card type. And based on the input parameter value, it will create one of the credit card object. That is, if the credit card type is money back, then it will create money back object. If the credit card type is titanium, then it will create an instance of titanium. And if the type is platinum, then it will create an instance of platinum object. And it will store that the instance in the credit card super interface reference variable, and finally return that object through the credit card super interface variable. Now the client needs to create the object through the credit card factory. For example, if the client wants to create an instance of a platinum credit card, then he or she needs to pass platinum as the type to the get credit card method of the credit card factory class. Now the get credit card method will create a platinum class instance and return that instance to the client, right? So let us create the credit card factory class. I have already created a class file with the name creditcardfactory.cs. This is going to be our factory class. As you can see, the getCreditCard method takes the credit card type as input parameter, and based on the card type value, it will create the appropriate credit card instance and store that instance in the super interface credit card reference variable, and finally return that instance through the superclass reference variable to the caller of this method. Now from the client code, let's move to the program class. The main method is nothing but our client. Now from the client code, we need to call the getCreditCardStatic method by passing the appropriate credit card type. So what we need to do is creditcardfactory.getCreditCard, and we need to pass the type that we want. So we need to remove these things. We also don't require all these things right now, right? So that's it. For example, if you want an instance of the platinum credit card, then you need to pass platinum as the card type to the getCreditCard method, and this method will create and return an instance of the platinum class, and then we call the methods like this. Now run the application and you will get the output as expected. Yes, we are getting the platinum credit card details as expected. Let's move to the presentation. Real life example of factory design pattern. From layman's point of view, we can say that a factory is a place where products are created. In other words, we can say that it is a centralized place for creating products. Later, based on the order received, the appropriate product is delivered by the factory. For example, a car factory can produce different types of car. If you are ordering a car to the car factory, then based on your requirement, or you can say specification, the car factory will create the appropriate car and then deliver that car to you. The same thing is also happens in the factory design pattern. A factory, that is a class, will create and deliver product, that is object, based on the incoming parameters. When to use factory design pattern in a real-time applications, right? It would not be a good programming approach to specify the exact class name while creating the objects by the client, which leads to tight coupling between the client and the product. To overcome this problem, we need to use the factory design pattern in C#. This design pattern provides the client with a simple mechanism to create the object. So we need to use the factory design pattern in C# when the object needs to be extended to the subclasses. Classes don't know what exact subclasses it has to create. The product implementation going to change over time, and the client remains unchanged. Problems of simple factory design pattern. The following are the problems of simple factory design patterns. If we need to add any new product, that is new credit card, then we need to add a new if else condition in the get credit card method of the credit card factory class. This violates the open close solid design principle. We also have a tight coupling between the factory, that is the credit card factory class, and the product classes, that is money back, titanium, and platinum. In the next video, I am going to discuss how to overcome the above problem by using the factory method design part. In the next video, I am going to discuss how to overcome the simple factory design pattern problem by using the factory method design pattern in C# with examples. Here in this video, I try to explain the factory design pattern in C# with examples. I hope you enjoy this video. In case you need the code and text version of this video, then the link for the same is provided in the video description section. Thank you for watching this video.